city loves something that they can cheer for, something that's great, it's free, people of all walks of life come to. It's a great opportunity for vendors to showcase their product or their movement, whatever they're doing, whatever they believe in. I've learned about so many vendors just from showing up and checking some people out at some tents. Got great beer, great craft beer. Got some great bands, City in Color. The Weeks just played and killed it. I love coming back to Live on the Green.
This is our second year coming to Live on the Green. It's a great event. The fact that it's free and they bring in artists that are new and local. It's held in August, so the weather is perfect.
Absolutely perfect.
It's just great to see the community turn out, and there's always a ton of people. It's getting bigger every year. People that are new to town or don't know much about Nashville, this is a great experience and a great opportunity.
Get you out of the house.
It gets bigger and better every year. You know, we're always anxious to see the direction it's going.
Thousands of people here tonight, wandering around downtown. The streets are closed. People don't get to experience this very often in Nashville, and it should be safer. There's probably about a dozen food trucks lined up, with no fewer than 20 people in each line. So from that alone, you can tell that it brings people down here. People are bringing money into this area, and they're spending it. So it's good for the downtown area. It's good for these bands. It's good exposure for them. Bringing that kind of festival-like atmosphere to the downtown area is pretty amazing. And I mean, only a couple cities pull it off, and those cities are top-tier cities, which is where Nashville's trending. Who knows what Live on the Green will look like in the next couple years.